terrorizing the local wildlife.
Thank you. Thank you. Erebor swallows another day.
Have only the finest goods.
Thank you.
See you later.
Agritelus paramenó.
Αθωότατο σημείο.
Έλα. Come on.
kill. Thank you. What's this? A message.
you've arrived! I'm honored that the Castis would accept my humble request.
Your Atlas, I take it?
In the flesh. I thank you for coming to see me. I'm sure you're very busy. The burden my father gave you is not a light one.
I seem to have a lot to do around here, thanks to Poseidon. But if I can help, I will.
A noble pursuit. As my messenger stressed, the situation is dire. The Dicastis is just who I need.
Well, here I am.
It's my brothers, the Archons. They have issues with the human populations under their control. Tensions between Isu and humans are mounting. Without order, the problems will grow severe.
I'll try to use my position to help them where I can.
Find Hadiros, Amphiris, and Azeas. Through your shining example, I hope they learn the valuable lessons in discipline they so desperately need.
And if I help them, you're hoping it'll maintain the peace between Isu and humans.
That's the plan. Poseidon should have known they weren't ready for the responsibility an Archon bears. But that's his failing.
Tell me about Hadiros.
You'll find him near the arena, hard at work planning his next exhilarating spectacle, I'm sure.
What should I know about Amphiris?
He's probably off terrorizing people near the fortified Doma of Ochtonos. Make sure you don't sneak up on him. He's quite jumpy.
What about Azaius? Who is he?
You'll find dear Azaius wherever there is humanitarian work to be done. I heard there were some issues near the Doma of Amphiris.
We have Archons where I'm from. Do they fulfill the same duties?
They are charged with overseeing and ruling the humans of Atlantis. Ensuring all live comfortably and peacefully. A job at which I fear they're failing.
There always seems to be unrest between the two races. The Underworld and Elysium were no different.
Time passes and tensions keep building. I expected my father to handle it. But Atlantis grows steadily worse, and no one wants to see what could happen if precautions are not taken.
I'll find the Archons and make sure their problems are taken care of. I should be extra careful in this area.
Yeah! Ты сосвалишься на лавьести. Ah, the Castis. I heard you can help me with the solar floral regeneration project.
The what?
Oh, forgive me. Let me start from the beginning. I'm Neocles, an imperial botanist here in Atlantis. I'm engineering a way to aid floral regrowth.
The flowers here can't just grow on their own?
Oh, no! You're not one of those followers of Minerva, are you?
If you don't start making sense, I'm not going to know how to help you.
Oh, apologies, Nicastis. You're new to Atlantis, and I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me begin. Basically, the plants are a key resource for us here. But a few cycles ago, humans overpicked them, and now the air is suffering.
You want to grow more?
In a sense, yes. I have a hypothesis, a theory that using a natural power source stronger than the sun will promote sustainable growth.
You're losing me again.
There are devices that project beams of light around the Garden of Triton. Redirecting them using the reflective surfaces would stimulate floral regrowth.
You want me to move your lights?
Yes! And the Castis, taking care of our natural resources, would send a message to all of Atlantis.
A good message, I hope. It looks like all the light beams need to hit that central structure. That must be the device Neocles mentioned. Reminds me of how I opened the door to Atlantis. Something's in the way. That worked! First one down. Won't budge. Something's blocking this. Get the flowers growing in no time. Thank you. That should do it. I'll tell Neocles it's done. That doesn't seem good. What happened? I moved your light beams. It seemed to be working, but then...
The beams are aligned, yes, but the power isn't running.
What do you think the problem is?
None of this makes any sense. The light beams should expand across the gardens and present with enhanced photons.
There might be something wrong with your theory. I still don't see how this light is any better than the sun.
The sun! That's it! The power source must also be displaced, rendering this light no different than the sun. No wonder you're the Dicastis. That's brilliant!
So the next step is...
Go to the control room and make sure the power source isn't displaced.
And what exactly is this source?
An igneous matter consisting of imperial... It's a rock. Just make sure there's a rock in the control room.
Fine. I'll go see if this rock is there. Looks like Neocles was right. There is no rock here.
Hey! Stop right there! Get back here! Malaka!
What's the Dicastis doing running around here?
I'm chasing down a thief. Looks like you're the one who took Neocles' rock.
My name is Melita. I'm an environmental biologist, not a thief. Neocles has no claim to a natural power source like this.
That rock must be worth a lot if you're trying to steal it.
You're the Dicastis and you have no idea what the power source is? Aren't you invested in the future of our resources?
It's easy. Put the rock in Neocles' device, and we'll fix the flowers.
This isn't Neoclesis' first attempt at population balancing. When the flowers were overpicked and the bees started dying, first he attempted to artificially pollinate the flowers. When he artificially pollinated the flowers, the soil degraded. When the soil...
I get the idea. But then, how would you fix the gardens?
I wouldn't. Nature has been healing itself for eons. Neocles needs to stop meddling.
Melita! You've always been obtuse about the project. No accountability for civilization's impact on the ecosystem.
Insanity is trying the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. When will you accept your hypothesis has failed?
Failed is inaccurate terminology. I simply adjusted my theory after experiencing unintended results.
Enough bickering, both of you.
You're right. I wanted to destroy the power source to end his project once and for all. But as the Dicastis, it should be your decision.
All right, give me the rock. I'll end this once and for all.
Are you mad? You've completely annihilated our chances at future sustainability!
Trust in Gaia. Nature will heal itself if you allow it.
Thank you, Dicastis. This is the right direction to go in. We might not see improvements right away, but the gardens will heal themselves.
They said it would take time for the gardens to heal, but
those flowers don't look good.
I wonder what she'd make of these.
The one who holds the staff has no choice but to face both immediate and future consequences for lifetimes. That takes responsibility.
I hear you, Alethea. You may think I'm crazy, but at least I'm accountable. murderer!
Murderer? I didn't do it!
Stop her before she kills again!
Leave me alone!
Want to tell me what that was all about?
No. I'll be fine. The Castis! You can make this all go away! My name is Lyra, and you're... you! You've helped so many people. You're amazing and wonderful and powerful and... and you're here!
Enough. I don't like whatever it is you're doing.
Forgive me, it's just... that your being here confirms all the legends. You're real! To be face to face with you right now, it's... sorry.
They called you a murderer. You don't seem the type, but as the Castis, I have to be sure.
They're sure I'm responsible for what happened to that poor family. They said it's like the other murders, but I couldn't live with myself, I swear. Please, please clear my name.
Where were you when the family was murdered?
If it happened last night, like they said, I was here trying to sleep. Although, lately it's been restless, filled with strange dreams. It's always the same one, over and over.
Were you alone?
Well, yes. I've been so tired lately, I decided to stay in.
You said something about other murders.
This was the third time. I just don't understand why they'd blame me. I don't have the stomach to do that.
I'll find out what really happened. Just point me in the direction of the attack.
Just down the road. Not too far from here.
If I were you, I'd hide until I return.
Oh, good idea. Thank you. You truly are a great de Castis. Please find out what happened. I'm not a murderer. I know it. Please find out what happened. I'm not a murderer. I know it. Find out what happened. I'm not a murderer. I know it.
Maybe someone around here saw what happened last night.
Is this about what happened last night?
How do you know?
It's all everyone's talking about. And if the Tichastis is here, you must be looking into it.
If you saw or heard anything, I need to know.
I saw it from the distance. Heard it too. Its howl will never leave my mind.
You saw a wolf?
Beast is more like it. If you see it, run!
I'll be careful.
Ah! The great de Castis! What did I do to deserve a visit?
I'm looking into the attack that happened nearby last night.
Ah, of course. I thought that was meant to be handled already.
You mean the mob harassing that woman?
I've said enough.
I'm the Castis, remember? Trust me, people who don't tell me what I want to know end up regretting their silence.
You've already met the guilty one.
Lyra?
You agree with the mob?
Of course I do. I'm the one who told them it was her. I saw her last night, bloody and in a frenzy.
It was dark. How do you know it was her?
I know what I saw.
These footprints track the blood out of the house. Whoever murdered them left this way. These aren't stab wounds. They're claw marks. This bloody cloth doesn't match the mother or daughter's robes. It must have come off the murderer. I should return to Lyra and let her know what I found.
Well, did you find out what happened?
The evidence I found was conflicting.
Tell me.
Two people saw what happened. One woman heard a wolf howling, but a man said he saw you, covered in blood, and leaving the family's house.
He's lying!
Or mistaken. It was dark, so it could have been anyone. There's more. The killing blows weren't made by a weapon.
Then by what?
It almost looked like claw marks. And then there was this piece of cloth. It didn't match the clothes of anyone there.
That's mine! How did it get there? Someone wants me to look like I was responsible. Tell me the truth, DiCastis.
Whether it was a wolf or something else, it's clear it wasn't you.
Of course it wasn't, but why would someone make it seem like I'm the murderer?
We'll figure that out together. After I killed the beast.
You're going to kill it?
What other choice is there? Do you want another mob after you?
No, of course not. I've just always hated the killing of animals.
If I don't kill it now, it will kill someone later.
I have a friend who can keep me safe while you end this.
I need to find the beast and kill it before it grows bloodthirsty again.
It was me! What am I?
I've seen this before. A Minotaur, a Cyclops, a Gorgon. All were humans possessed by powerful Isu devices. The only way I could stop them was by killing them. But you're able to change back. Somehow, you're different.
I don't remember coming here. Or why?
If I had to guess, that side of you knew it was caught. Maybe it thought coming out here was the only choice it had.
That side of me. I've had dreams lately of being in a bright room, tied down, pain throughout my body. But now, I think that all really happened. I did kill them then. I don't remember it, but it was me, wasn't it? If you knew you would harm people again, and you could never control yourself, never stop, would you?
Would I what?
Jump?
Of course I wouldn't. There are always answers.
How could that be? It feels so permanent.
It's only one part of you. It's not all of you. I know what it's like to be part human and part something else. Trust me, you can live with this burden.
I'm not as strong as you are.
Look at yourself. Yes, you are. You're stronger than you think. Plus, I've been thrown off a cliff before. I wouldn't recommend it.
But you're still here.
I am. And you are too.
You're right. Now that I know what's inside of me, I can do something about it. And I know who can help. Thank you.
Technology can and will change whoever isn't strong enough to command it. That explains your own aggression, Layla.
I'm still me. I'm not as weak as you think I am. Thank you.